Meanwhile, you have the entire media still trying to blame Fox News for all of this, despite the fact that Omicron is hitting pretty much everyone, including the triple vaxxed. Again, people who are vulnerable should be getting vaxxed. I have been saying this consistently since day one. My wife is triple vaxxed. Both my parents are triple vaxxed. I am double vaxxed because I'm 37 years old. And after a consultation with Marty McCary at Johns Hopkins University, he has suggested that there's really no necessity for me to get the booster shot because I have T cell and B cell memory. And in any case, Joy Reid is still maintaining the case that if you don't listen to Joy Reid, this means you want people to die for fun.
Probably right. The most vaccinated company in America is Fox News. They're all vaccinated. They're going to live through this and let their viewers and their fans right. die because they don't give a damn. It's just clicks to them. It's just, they don't care what happens. It's just, this is fun for them.
It's fun for them. It's fun for them to watch their viewers die. Again, they can't let go of the moral narrative. They'll never let go of the moral narrative. Just a reminder, the moral narrative that was originally driven by the left was the narrative that you must not greenlight the vaccine in the first place. Technologyreview.com, October 19th, 2020. One doctor's campaign to stop a COVID-19 vaccine being rushed through before Election Day. How heart doctor Eric Topol used his social media accounts to kill off Trump's October surprise. Okay, remember, it was the left that was pushing hard to not allow the FDA and CDC to clear distribution of the vaccine because Trump was still president. Remember, Pfizer was supposed to clear the vaccine like the last week of October, right before the election. And people, for political reasons, decided they would rather see 100,000 Americans die than allow the vaccine to be greenlit under Trump. According to Technology Review, after being released from Walter Reed National Military Medical Center on October 5th, U.S. President Donald Trump praised the doctors who treated him for COVID-19, promised the public would soon have a vaccine against the deadly coronavirus. We have the best medicines in the world, and very shortly, they're all getting approved, and the vaccines are coming momentarily, he said in a video. Across the country in California, a doctor named Eric Topol was responding in real time on social media. He questioned the president's health, his doctor's action, even his mental status. By that point, Topol, a heart expert and researcher with a huge Twitter following, was already weeks into a personal campaign to make sure the administration could not rush a COVID-19 vaccine through regulatory authorization before Election Day on November 3rd. An editorial in the New York Times had raised the possibility of an October surprise vaccine back in June and warned that a vaccine approval could turn into a campaign stunt. Topol aimed to prevent Trump from greenlighting a vaccine before scientists could prove it to be safe and effective. If Trump badgered the FDA into prematurely releasing a vaccine, it could shake the public's trust in any COVID-19 vaccine. Releasing a vaccine that people are afraid of could do more harm than good. So Topol led online calls for FDA Commissioner Steve Hahn to resign after his agency was criticized for cowing to political pressure, and then phoned Hahn to urge him to resist Trump's influence. Topol targeted Pfizer, which eventually set up a meeting for him with its vaccine team. Topol and his allies claimed success on October 16th. Pfizer CEO Albert Bourla said the company would not be able to seek emergency approval for its vaccine before the third week in November, owing to safety standards that had been put in place by the FDA. Those standards had been issued against Trump's wishes at the urging of Topol and other advocates. So remember, all these people who say it's all apolitical, it's all about fighting the virus, they literally delayed the distribution of this vaccine by at least a month, which meant probably 100,000 dead Americans from Delta because of this. Because they desired that Trump not get his October surprise. So never tell me that politics has not been a part of this. It's been a part of this since the very damned beginning. And people have died because of it, for sure. But that ain't all on Trump and the vax deniers. A lot of that is on the left. You know how insane it is that Eric Topol, one doctor at Scripps, basically prevented hundreds of thousands of Americans from getting the vaccine at, say, the beginning of January rather than the middle of February? It's totally crazy. We're in a battle for the culture and for our values. Like and subscribe to help keep our videos on the front line of the fight and top of your feed.